Do you saw that? Do you think this is the correct way of practicing Kapalbhati Kriya? No, right? I'll show you how to do Kapalbhati Pranayama or Kriya in the correct manner. Welcome to Yoga Fitness with Priyanka Sharma. So in today's class, I am going to teach you Kapalbhati. Kapal is your skull, mane matha, or bhati is to shine your skull or to release the unwanted gas from your body and unwanted the blockages which is like in sinus or those who have migraine. So all these are the signs that you have cold and cough and blockages in your respiratory system. So friends, I would like to tell you one thing about Kapalbhati Kriya is it is counted in Shad Kriya, that is a cleansing process. So there are six cleaning processes, in that the sixth one is Kapalbhati, but it is included in Pranayam because this is known as Sanjeevani Pranayam. Kapalbhati is Sanjeevani Pranayam because it's a very good it gives you a life. It's a life process, it's a life-giving pranayam. So in this pranayam, we are going to first learn the technique of Kapalbhati Kriya. Aapko mat lena hai, you have to sit in a comfortable position and also make sure that you are in empty stomach while doing Kapalbhati Kriya. You're not having a heavy or bloated, or make sure you're not in periods while doing Kapalbhati Kriya. Women's just make sure, note down somewhere. Also, those who have surgery or those who are pregnant ladies, you should avoid for at least a few months. For the surgery people, you should avoid for 6 months of Kapalbhati Kriya, and for the pregnant ladies and for periods women, you should not practice Kapalbhati Kriya. So this is a limitation of Kapalbhati Kriya. Now moving to the technique part. So for that you have to sit in Dhyan or Jnana Mudra. Just place it on your knees, keeping your spine straight, because we want the energy to flow upward, right? That's why we keep our spine straight always. And keep a smile on your face, relax your face. So first thing I will like to start with placing my palm on my nabhi or on my stomach. Because while doing Kapalbhati Kriya, I should feel that my stomach is moving in and out, like flapping my belly in and out constantly, right? And what mistakes I showed you earlier, like people do it, they shake their head, they inhale instead of exhalation. So that is the wrong way of practicing. The correct way is you breathe out. It's like a sneezing. If you are if their nose is running, aap kya karte ho? Agar bahut naak run hota hai to aapko nikalna hai naak se mucus nikalna hai, to aap kaise karte ho? Like this way, right? Same way you have to practice Kapalbhati Kriya by just exhalation. To ye jab bhi main karti hu to bhi pet kya hota hai, pet andar bahar, andar bahar. So I'll do it with the counting. Let's do it together. Take a deep breath in. We'll just do it 10 stroke. Inhale, exhale forcefully. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Inhale is automatic and exhalation is what I was, making aware of. So I was being aware of my exhalation. So this pranayam is amazing for those who are having migraine, those who are having sinus, those who have blockage of the heart, blockage of the arteries. That is why I'm saying Kapalbhati has incredible, immense benefits. Like those who have diabetes, because it has direct connection with the abdomen. Jathra Agni, we say Jatharagni, that means the belly where the digestive system is there. So it increases the fire element in the body, right? So while pressing our belly in and out, it activates our fire element. So it is very good for digestive system. It is good for constipation people, those who have vata problem, like too much of constipated, like they feel their bones are weak. So the Kapalbhati helps to increase the urja in the body, that is a fire in the body. Only make sure those who have high blood pressure in summers, you should avoid doing Kapalbhati Kriya. Especially in winters and in rainy season, you should do Kapalbhati more, at least for 10 to 15 minutes you can do it, but do it in the break. So like 10 times and you pause, then again you do it for 10 times and you again pause. So it will help you in your daily routine. Now those who want to even increase the immune system, because of this corona, most of them feel weakness, a weak body. So while doing Kapalbhati Kriya, they have a very good effect in their activating in their cells. Yeah, we also have alveoli which are just below our lungs. It's in a balloon shape. So those are unutilized. Yeah, so that's why the lungs is only 40% used. 60% are dead. So to activate the lung cells, we practice Kapalbhati Kriya. So Kapalbhati has so many benefits. So I hope you guys will practice Kapalbhati Kriya at home, and also suggest your friends and family, those who have corona, those who have a low immune system, those who are feeling low, those who have kapha problem, those who have vata problem, those who have blockages. Only make sure, as I said, if you have too intense blood pressure, or if you have heart problem, any surgery, pregnant ladies, period ladies, has to be little cautious with this pranayam. So I hope you will like this video. Thank you guys for watching this video. Do like, do share and comment how did you like it. Namaste, stay blessed.